this is original navigator, full up on navigation, don't need no recommendation and don't need no confirmation. Understand me? Original jungle gun, five-star general. I mean, I tell you, say jungle music forever. Don't miss it.
Okay, so where with MC Navigator outside Jungle Mania?
Jungle Mania. Give me that question again.
Yeah, there wasn't a question. You took the mic too quick. Right, Navi, so obviously you've been there from the beginning, the same as, you know, Fivo, the same as Moose,
yeah,
same as a lot of other people.
For real, man.
How would you say Jungle Mania tonight,
yeah,
differs to how Jungle Raves were back in the mid-90s?
I'll tell you this straight, yeah? I have never seen a lineup like this yet, ever. First time I saw the lineup, I was like, rotted. Hold on a minute now. General Levy with MB live, Congo Natty. You ain't even got to go no further than that. I never seen them two on one lineup properly here in the UK yet. You know what I mean? With the same man that was on stage tonight. So to me, it was already a legendary thing. You know what I mean? And I felt honored actually to be involved in it. You know what I'm saying? So big respect to Jungle Mania for that, man. One off.
Why do you think the demand for jungle music has lasted so long?
Because jungle music is a groundbreaking phenomenon. It's a worldwide phenomenon. It's something that was grown out of this city right here. And if you're born and growing this city right here, so you know, London, you know, it's a serious city, you know. So you know, so from your born here, so you know, you can go anywhere in the world and survive. From your born and growing in London. So you see jungle music, it born in London. So jungle music can go anywhere in the universe and survive. Can't dead, can't done, foundation, groundation. Can't argue with it, man. You know what I'm saying? Pop industry had to, that the industry, the music industry had to heads up, take note and say, yes, jungle music, we're recognizing that as a genre. You understand? I'm proud to have been a part of it, man.
So you've been around for a very long time, obviously from the beginning.
True that.
Can you share with us some of your great jungle memories?
Great jungle memories, too many. Too many. But I'll tell you about my greatest jungle memories before I was even emceeing on jungle. And I was in those parties listening to those music. Yeah, you're talking about top five, yeah? Alright, let us give you one. 28 Gun Bad Boy, yeah? And We IE. Yeah, them two tunes. Because you see, when I heard the B-lines, remember, I come from dub because I come from 70s. And when we first start chat sound at 1980, me start chat sound. So them time they appear dub music and reggae dancehall, original reggae dancehall, Dennis Brown, Gregory Isaac, Sugar Mine Hat. Them man there, Barrington Levy. See? So when I hear the B-line come back now, because when we first started going to dance them, it was just bleepy. But then when them tunes came and the B-line came, I was like, yes, yes, now we know. You understand?
What does it mean to you to perform at Jungle Mania?
Right now, it feels very blessed, and I feel honored, as I said. I know it's bare jungle dons in here tonight. I just saw General Levy just rip the ass out of that in there, trust me. Tore it to shreds, you know? And that's testament to the music. What are you gonna say now? 20 years on, the man just ripped the ass out of that, yeah? Slap way. All right, I don't talk.
All right, last one. Give me five of your most favorite jungle tunes.
Five of my favorite jungle tunes. All right, so well, I've already given you two. 28 Gun Bad Boy, We IE, yeah? Let me really, really think about this now. I have to say original Nutter, right? Because I remember when the tune was made and I was around Shy FX and all them boys there and we saw the development, so we have to really big up Shy FX and UK Apache for what they've done with that track. That was another big one, yeah? But let me think good now. Five really big ones, you know. You see this brother here named LTJ Bookham, yeah? Oh my gosh, he make a tune there. What the tune here? Music. What was the tune that Bookham got? Music. See that tune there, yeah? That just bring tingles down my spine. That tune there. And anywhere you go in the world, because them tunes are known like that all over the world. You understand me? Sure. Big tunes, man. And then I'm gonna say more fire. And the reason why I'm going to say more fire, even though it wasn't back there in the jungle days, right, it kind of brought back that jungle vibe to drum and bass, you know what I'm saying? And Fresh got on it, and Spied Up, Big Up Yourself, you understand? And that was my first hit, and it took me 10 years to get that hit, but I was determined to get a jungle hit, yeah? Because I'm a Navigator. I have to have a jungle hit, the way I said.